Hello, fans. This is Dink and my partner Smash, and we're coming to you live from a remote in-home studio. As many of you have had to change your workplace, we have as well, and we hope to return soon. We don't know if it'll be by Easter, but return to our Richmond Pickleball Club studio. Smash, why don't we share with our viewers this this COVID-19 safety device that you and I engineered?
Well, sure. Dink, this is something that we use here while we're broadcasting, and occasionally Dink and I go out walking, and we hold on to this and to space ourselves so we have the correct spacing when we go out walking.
Yeah,
it comes in pretty handy.
And then sometimes when we see people coming our way, we hold it up and kind of catch them neck high.
Yeah,
and
that's
then
right.
they know to go around.
And occasionally we stop and measure that for them too. Also, we say, "Are you guys 6 feet apart? Here, you can use our measuring device.
Right. Yeah, get away
and see if you're actually 6 feet away."
So. Okay. Well, you know, for those of you out there in pickleball land, maybe that might be a marketing possibility. Maybe we could have a fundraiser for the Richmond Pickleball Club.
And you notice we're wearing gloves, and Dink is wearing a respirator. I'm wearing a bandana to try to keep us safe.
Good. Now tell us about our setup here today before we have our guests come on.
Well, before that,
yeah,
I want to ask you how you came about having the name Dink.
Good question. Well, in our club, we have people with a lot of different type of skills, but I'm probably one of the most skilled dinkers.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
In the pickleball club. And I must say that Bruce Borden has really helped bring my game up to the next level. How about you, Smash?
Well, I'm not very talented, but I do have the tendency of trying to smash and hit people feet. I don't try to hit
people's
them.
Feet with what? Your paddle?
No, with the ball.
Oh, okay.
And their toes. And occasionally, what has happened, they've had to call a tow truck after I hit their toes. So that's why they call me Smash.
Well, I understand that. You're right about the first part when you said you're not very good. Okay, now, today's program is going to be a little different. We're going to have two guests on the show, and they're going to take our place. And in just a moment, you get to meet Lob and Serb. And what they're going to do is they're going to share with you their observations of some of our Richmond Pickleball Club players. So right now, this is Dink and Smash signing out, and we're going to turn it over to Lob and Serb.
Thank you, Smash and Dink. We're pleased to be here today. So Lob, what can you tell our viewers what difference between you and me? I mean, we're both ballers and bounce around a lot.
Well, Serb, I think one of the obvious differences is that you represent one of our oldest sports, while I represent the current fastest growing sport in the country. Also, you use that silly system that begins with the word love, which
who cares?
No one understands it. And we keep it simple.
Who cares?
We keep it simple with 002. Now let's share some of those observations.
Who cares?
Let's share some of those observations about some of the Richmond pickleball players. First we have Tom. Now Tom's also known, do you know that? He's known as the Banana Man.
Oh, that's strange.
He was the first to wear protective latex gloves to the courts and disinfect the pickleballs.
I heard people laughed at him.
Well, and then there's Tim M. You know, he's a player who launches some of the best lob shots I've ever seen.
I've heard him. He's a legend.
The problem is that many of them go into the ceiling. Yep, yep, yep.
Well, that's not good.
But then there's also, you know, his wife, Wanda. She hits frequent shots into the net. Have you seen that? And it's usually followed by the words, "Oh, crap."
I've heard about her.
And, of course, we have our smashers, you know, Ruben, Nick, Phil, and Gus, who have a return percentage of about 40%.
That's not good.
And, you know, even some of our players, they get upset and go home.
Aw.
Now, sir, why don't you share some of your thoughts?
Who does this sound like? Bruce, do you give up yet? With the response usually being, shut up. Of course, there's Crazy Joe, who keeps his opponents laughing and off balance with comments like, hey, Susan, kitchen is a NCZ.
Yeah, and you know Crazy Joe, he has to do that because he has to some way make up for his lack of skill. So he gets people just laughing and he goofs around and nobody wants to be his partner.
His supportive wife, Naomi, is present on injury reserve. Continues to heckle players from the bleachers.
Well,
now Dudley, we can't forget him. He definitely needs to spend more time practicing his skills after that singing and playing his guitar. And what better time to practice pickleball hand-eye coordination activity at home since this lockdown is in place. That makes it impossible for him to frequent the courts and bars. Finally, I want to mention a couple more names before we sign off. We must recognize Laura, the queen of the RPC. She brings her advanced skills and adds an international flavor to the game. And finally, we do have some good laughs at our games. One of our most versatile, agile, and quickest players, whose name need not to be mentioned at times, doesn't appear to be stably challenged.
I want to apologize to all of our pickleball fans out there today. It's obvious. Serve didn't rehearse his lines. He's just kind of doing it cold. Well, sir.
Who cares?
Well, sir, let's give a shout out to Smash and Dink for inviting us to be here today. From all of us at the Richmond Pickleball Club Studio, we want to remind our fans in pickleball land to stay off the courts with more than four people. Don't meet at the net. Stay well and stay tuned for future Dink and Smash Pickleball videos. Until then, we say,
pickle!